Yeah, Steve Winwood, Freedom Overspill. We're doing music that my dad would listen to since it's his birthday, or would have been his birthday. 68.
It's still his birthday.
It's still his birthday, but he would have been 68. It's the Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95, also known as the Sons of Gary. That's what they call us on the streets. So it's a Gary birthday, so you got to do Gary music. Groundhog Day, we got to rock.
We got to figure something out.
Gary music for you. I'm Dan Soder, that's Big J Okerson. Joining us in studio, friend, comedian,
foe,
confidant, sometimes nemesis, hilarious comedian, Mateo Lane.
Oh, my, there's a crowd.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
We only do our shows in stadiums.
Wow, dude. That's great.
So we're, before you came on the show, we were talking about Rob Thomas was in the the building.
From Matchbox 20?
Oh, yeah.
Is there still a Matchbox 20?
There is a, is there still
no,
a
Matchbox? No, now he seems to be fronting Chicago.
Yeah.
Like the old band from the 70s?
Whoa.
All
Let's
right,
pump
Mateo.
The brakes, Mateo. You're young.
First of all, they were also around in the 80s.
Yes, they were very popular.
They've never stopped touring.
They're like didn't they sing with Linda Ronstadt a lot?
No. What?
I feel like that was the Eagles. Era. That was the Eagles.
Okay, don't you ever call Chicago the Eagles, Mateo.
I don't or know. Guys,
you go, I'll come over there. I swear. I will.
Mateo.
I don't know. I have to.
Do you know ZZ Top?
Yes.
Okay, do you know the song LaGrange?
I mean, I've heard it.
You know this lick.
This lick.
Mateo.
Yeah, I know this.
If you don't know,
you're gonna
Chicago, you're gonna have to go. They got a lot of other shows in this building. Oh!
We've been doing that for 15 minutes.
I mean, I listen to Mariah Carey. I have no business talking about ZZ Top.
That's okay.
Yeah.
Nothing wrong with Mariah Carey.
Well, there's a lot
wrong. Now
There's plenty wrong with Mariah Carey.
She's all fucked up now,
Is it just the wealth and in being insulated?
Well, her voice now sounds like beef jerky, so I think that has a lot to do with it. And she's taking a lot of pills, and she wears quinceañera dresses. It's not good.
She's taking a dive. I think it's like trying to wrap your brain around, like,
not being an athlete anymore.
Aging.
Yeah.
You know, it's like...
She can't do all the acrobats and the height. But she doesn't help her. I mean, Patti LaBelle can still sing, but she shouldn't help herself by the drinking.
Yeah, so she's like... So she is like an old weathered...
Oh, yes.
Is she? I mean, she always looks pretty good. I mean, she looks
She's kept it. She's
like a big-titted, fat-assed, like, older chick.
Yeah.
But she looks good.
She just, when she talks, she's real, like she's in under a haze, just tired, sleepy.
She's like, they gave me drugged like a circus chimp.
Mm-hmm.
But she had that
way I don't rip anyone's face off.
Didn't she have that Times Square meltdown?
Yeah.
She just quit in the middle of the song.
Yeah.
Like, fuck.
Actually, I was on her side for that because it seems like they fucked up the equipment and then she was like getting frustrated.
Yeah, but the thing is, girl, you've been in the industry now for how long?
14 years, honey. Oh, no. Oh, God damn it. I read that cue wrong.
Oh, there's a picture of Mariah.
Yes.
I saw her Christmas concert, which was half lip synced, and the red dress. She looks like a centaur. But she came out in that outfit, and there was a literal audible gasp from the audience. Like,
she looks like a 1920s trapeze artist.
Yeah, it looks like, well, no, because she can't lift herself up off the ground.
Yeah, I'm sorry. A trapeze artist who's lost it. She goes, I can't go in the sky.
And I've seen her live 7 times and felt nothing every time.
Really? And she's one of your favorite?
It's a love-hate. There was a group of gays next to us who were doing coke at her Christmas concert.
That's great.
Coke. That's the place.
God, gay guys really do know how to party all the time.
I mean, and first of all, at a Mariah Carey concert alone, that's weird to do coke.
All right, guys, I just want to get out
there. That's Mateo, not Mariah, by the way.
I just want to get out there before she hits.
He goes, listen here, honey.
I don't want to do Vision of Love before I'm out there. So
I swear to God, if she does Heartbreaker and I'm not a half eight ball in, I'm going to scratch someone's goddamn face off.
But I mean,
I'm going to suck off the horn player, see if I can get us backstage.
But it's a Christmas concert, so this would make more sense than her being like, Christmas time. Yeah. You know, I mean, it's like, what?
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, she's doing fucking All I Want for Christmas, and they're like, hold on, let me do a key bump. I feel it more.
And I brought Evan Williams with me, who's like a recovering coke addict, so I thought it'd be hysterical if he relapsed at a Mariah Carey Christmas concert.
Oh, where was it at?
It was at the Beacon Theater.
Oh, beautiful.
The theater was.
Yeah.
The show, not so much.
It was real
Nick
tough.
Nick Cannon, huh? Nick Cannon jumped in there too late in the game.
No, he got her at the right time and then ruined her. When he met her, she was super hot.
Do you blame him for her...
I blame Mariah.
You blame Mariah?
I think she's cuckoo bananas.
Yeah, you've been famous since you were 19. You can sing like an angel.
Stern used to play those audio clips, yeah, like her talking, yeah, her little lambs. She would, like,
yeah,
talk to her audience.
That's when she was losing it. She would leave messages on her her website, and, like, went right before she had that meltdown. She was drunk. And she was just like, everyone, I'm tired. Just maybe I won't. Like, it sounded very suicidal.
I swear to you, gay icons always go to become some pilled-up booze bag.
Well, it's just...
It's Liza Minnelli. It's
yes, but I just want to say, I've recovered, and I really feel a lot better.
Yeah, but they really do. It's the party lifestyle, and they just...
The first thing my mother said to me was, Liza, call an ambulance. But really funny.
Do you think that is Liza Minnelli, like... Is that the same thing that hampered Mariah Carey, where it's so much fame, so mm-hmm. much money, that you're just fucking destroyed?
It's just these gay men are just enabling these women to mental disorders.
They're like, go crazy!
Judy, Liza. I mean, Barbara has not gone off the deep end, but she's also secluded herself from the world forever.
I would say she lives in an ivory tower.
Yeah.
I mean, like, literally.
Yeah.
Like,
she's like, my chickens lay green eggs. And it's, all right, Barbara.
But she really is one of those people who's, like, just away from the world.
Yeah. And yeah, she's yeah. alive because of it. I mean, Mariah, I give her 15 years max.
Yeah.
Mariah, you so it's 2017, so you say by 2032 she's out.
Yeah, for sure.
All right.
I mean, Whitney Houston had a real long run.
Whitney Houston was, like, kept battling back. Like, she was down 3-1 and then even the series, and you're like, she might be all right. And then you're like, oh, she gets
done. Yeah, then the last 3 years of her life, you're like, yeah, it's about time.
Yeah.
That's cool. She did the best thing for her career. She died.
Yeah. Courtney Love does all that, though, too. Sometimes she pops up, and you're like, oh. She gets she pulled together. And
she's looking
like,
a little...
They're always like a 9-7 Steelers team. You're like, well, are they not going to make the playoffs? And well, then they do, and you're like, I think they win the fucking Super Bowl.
Madonna's the one that, like, I mean, she... Her face looks like
yikes.
The V for Vendetta.
She looks like she was half-bred with an alligator. Like, where it was an island of Dr. Moreau, where they're like, my greatest creation, a pop star mixed with a swamp monster.
Yeah. She really has the same body as Lance Armstrong.
Yeah.
Yes.
But, like, Madonna and Lance Armstrong the same build.
But if Lance Armstrong only lived in Florida.
Oh, and I watched some of that Rebel Heart tour Madonna thing on Showtime. I mean, her like fake playing the guitar at one point.
Oh,
so
please.
Like, oh,
can
yeah.
You find,
that's worth it.
Can you also find Celine Dion air guitaring?
It's the greatest
yes,
thing in the world.
Yes, Dan, I love that.
Not
you
air.
Know that.
When she fucking on VH1 Divas, I've watched
the
it a million
live.
Times.
Oh, yeah.
It's not that. It's the grossness of her in a pantsuit is when the other girl sings and she literally starts like just pumping her, like dick pumping. You're like, ew. Someone get Nana off the stage. She's dick pumping.
She was a fast machine.
If you look at the live,
Renee, look at me pumping my pelvis. Yes,
this is my pussy. Look at my fresh pussy.
And if you watch Celine Dion,
we'll put this out at the Bonfire SXM.
Go to the beginning again.
No, that's not the part. That's the best part. I'm telling you.
She was never even a little bit of rock and roll. And by the way, she's singing this with Anastasia, and I'm glad Anastasia's forgotten about. Oh God.
It's all these moms losing their shit. He was a fast
machine. He kept his motor clean. It's just so clean.
Yeah.
The part where she pumps her hips is my favorite thing in the world.
I feel like screaming faggot at this moment.
Oh. Here she goes.
Oh my God.
She's probably working back at a Target.
Is that Bono?
Yeah.
Also, I love
she
the early
like a,
aughts and their fashion.
Yeah, she looks like a casino worker.
It looks like.
Yeah, she
she's in
is.
Between shifts.
She's a blackjack dealer now?
Oh, and it's the second verse. It's the second verse where she does
Celine
it.
Celine is just so... You know what it is? It's, she's just that weird foreign...
Yeah, you're right. It's the foreign feel of American rock. You
yeah.
can't adapt it.
Watch here, dude.
Right here.
The audience hates this.
How you doing, Casino?
But Celine, no, you fast forward too far, Christine.
But Celine's voice is great.
Back up.
Yeah, I mean, Celine's...
Back up. Here we go.
This is really good for the listeners at home.
Oh, yeah, it's all visual.
Oh.
Everyone imagine...
So you just saw your mom blowing a guy.
Right there. Oh.
Imagine Gumby in a cancer wig, like pelvis.
Yeah. Where he's like...
Oh, look at me now. nah, I would flex my hips. All you know who'd love that is the top row.
Pow, pow, pow.
I took that. That man was a fast machine. I took him like this. Pow, pow. Even though I've only had sex with a 7-year-old man.
Rene, you keep my motor clean.
Some people say I can eat an apple through a fence.
Yeah. What I eat, it's like a snake. You can see what it is in my belly.
I mean, they might spook her.
Yeah.
Hey, AC/DC was not thrilled.
This is what AC/DC had in mind when they...
Were they mad about that?
They were not into it, certainly.
Wouldn't you be mad about it? I'm mad about it now. I don't even care about AC/DC.
But I love that.
I don't care about AC/DC either. That's appalling.
That is pretty douche.
That was really embarrassing to watch.
Guys, yeah. I'm thinking for the set, maybe I do an AC/DC, and they go,
Celine, why don't we go with the old classic ballad?
Yeah, and they go,
Mom, I would like, if it's okay with you to do this AC/DC song, you shook me all night long.
I don't know what the fuck they could have paid this thing to have, like, this weird assortment, like Anastasia, like, who is
she? Super popular in Europe, like, when I was, like, 15, 16, because I remember being in Italy and my cousins were like, Anastasia's the best. And I was like, no, she's not.
Who is Anastasia? Madonna.
Oh, this is when Madonna falls. I love when Madonna gets the cape ripped off her and she just falls to the ground. Bye, girl.
At the Bonfire SXM. I mean, that's a solid 4 steps down.
Well, my thing is that the real skill in this is that the sound guy had to turn her lip syncing part off.
Oh. Wait, yeah, play with the full volume, Lou. Like, I want to hear
it. I let down my yoke.
And why are there just gay men and horns?
I let down my pipe.
The most scared person is Lourdes, because you know Lourdes is going to get it when she gets home.
Yeah, but you know Madonna didn't. She made that old man falling down noise. And she goes, oh, there we go. watch out. Here we go.
Because I'm crazy.
Here it comes. Oh, shit. Now. It's turned on her mic.
Who's doing the falling down? Oh,
get into the groove for... What? Hang on. Got it. I'm going.
Hold on. She goes like this. It's attached.
There's a dog.
Somebody could do me a favor and just... Because one little clip's not coming. Okay. All right. Don't pull, Zach. Hey.
You see her play it again? Play it from the top? She goes like this. She goes,
It's clipped on.
Desmond, it's clipped. It's clipped. Not yet.
Describe that one sentence.
It's clipped.
Ah, fuck. I thought this was Velcro.
Yep.
When she gets up, she goes, I'm okay. She was on
the ground in a huddle, and she goes, oh, you faggots are fired.
Because I'm crazy for you.
She goes, I'm going to lay more waste than the bathhouses in the 80s. Because they're all done. You're done. Do you understand? You're done. I'm going to run through you guys like AIDS. Yeah, she goes, I am fucking Madonna. You are all done. All right, get back up. Get my cape.
And Madonna's now in her early hundreds, so that fall could have killed her.
Dude, what if that would have sidelined the tour because of a busted hip?
I mean, listen, she's a Methuselah up there trying to, like, sing and dance still and be sexy. And it just, Ariana Grande falls on stage. You know Mariah watches that on loop.
Oh, here it is.
Bye, girl, bye.
That wasn't bad. Good save.
That wasn't that bad.
Big deal. Most of the place just went, ooh, ass flash.
Yeah, whoa.
Her voice is so, like, she has, like, the diction of a fog machine.
Why? She just goes,
You can't understand a word she says.
Play some Ariana Grande.
Iggy Azalea.
Iggy Azalea. She's bottom heavy. I'm surprised that low center of gravity.
Iggy Azalea has so much implants in her butt, it doesn't matter if she falls.
Is it really? So she's just, that's just basically like
she
one of those
looks
bumper,
like an asshole.
That's like one of those bumper protectors.
I don't know.
Whoa! She fucking fell. Oh my god. She goes backwards off the stage.
Her ass literally dragged her up.
She went down though like she was going into like a fun party.
Dude, Ariana Grande's got fucking 2 falls.
Yeah, she's a real clumsy ass.
Like, why is Ariana Grande trying to be Mariah Carey?
Oh, you said it.
Well,
you
can
say
it.
I don't know. What is?
You said play some Ariana Grande.
She's in a Fiat right now because she's Italian.
Not just the video.
Oh, what's her mute? Is this her mute?
You gotta hear it. Oh, it's a concept piece.
And I know, and I know, and I know that you got everything
It's just nondescript music.
It's just all slurred together like she's hammered.
The only one who has worse diction than her is Janet Jackson, who just whispers through every song. Literally, am I wrong? And does it? And she also laughs at herself. Every Janet Jackson song.
Black Lou's agreeing with him on this one.
Every Janet Jackson song is this.
261 million.
You're always doing that. The fuck are you talking to, Janet?
But I mean,
I'm killing with this guy.
Ariana Grande had 261 million views.
I mean, I know.
What, we're bringing up Rhythm Nation? We didn't jerk off of this. Even Mateo did. To the Rhythm dance Nation. Steps.
Well, because she looked like a man.
Yeah, I didn't jerk
in this
off.
Video.
No, I didn't jerk off to Rhythm Nation.
What was the one with the silk size?
That's the way love goes?
No, what's the if? If was the one I jerked off to. I'm sorry. But
Janet Jackson can get it.
Oh, yeah.
She's hot.
I'm sorry that I'm just a union guy and I like jerking off the Rhythm
Nation.
Remember
the pictures came out of her with her bald box, suntanning?
Yeah.
But she looked a little older by that point.
Oh, this was the video I jerked off to.
If by Janet Jackson. I miss the 90s.
Yeah, we were allowed to be a little more sexual.
I don't know if it's an age thing or what. I never know, but. All that Ariana Grande, not that they don't have some songs that are just going to be catchy by nature, yeah. But I feel like these songs are like, they're so...
Well, it sounds
I think a song that's supposed to be nondescript, it doesn't have like verse hook or verse chorus,
and
verse chorus hook.
It also sounds like Siri singing it.
Yeah.
Everything
is
so auto-tuned.
I mean, yeah.
This is Janet. Now, Janet really loved a big warehouse with lighting and...
But like, I like this album. Short. I like this album though very much. The one where the guy's holding her titties, right?
Oh man.
Yeah, but Big J, you also love Barbara Streisand's Memory, which warms my heart.
It's true. It's very true.
Yeah, she does a dance where she dances in front of a dude and puts her head by his crotch.
You know
and
what?
The way she's dressed in the bamboo black. Oh man, Vanilla Dance.
Vanilla Dance coming out.
I
Vanilla
also Dan's miss going epic nuts. Entrances. Like this entrance is so gay and epic. I mean, where I want this.
Yeah.
Where's
and
this?
Look at the choreography. Oh, she's so hot. Get out of this. Move it. Yeah, there you go.
I mean, okay, now try and figure out what she's saying.
I've known this song for 20 years. I have no idea.
Of course. Of course not.
And what you guys don't realize is she's just giving directions to program a VCR.
Change inputs to TV video.
And she will laugh at herself at some point in this song.
Yeah. She goes,
when you record, put the tape in and make sure you have set it.
If somebody took the tab off, put a piece of tape over the tab.
Then make sure you don't record over my birthday.
So hot in this video.
Yeah, no. She's
yeah, right there. Oh, boy. Oh, man. If I didn't jerk off to that one time, I did it a million.
And all that guy went home was like, her pussy stank.
Long
day of dancing.
He went, yeah. He goes, okay, first off, Janet, don't grab my head like that. We are peers. And in my mind, at 13-year-old, I was like, that guy's probably going to kiss her pussy.
Oh, none of us knew the dancers were gay when we were kids. They can get it.
But those guys are jacked. Yeah. That's all I thought.
I was like,
their bodies move so well.
What, these guys should be in the WWF.
If these were girls, I'd kiss them. What do you think that means?
Let's talk about the bees and the bees.
Everyone's got a stinger in this world.
That's what I'm saying. It was great. I loved this video.
Oh, Janet, what a good time that was.
I mean,
she really. But it's funny how much she peaked and looks like in her. This is all her 30s,
mm-hmm.
like mid 30s, mm-hmm. I think.
Oh,
well,
right
she
there.
Was smart.
Oh,
she just got a nose job. She didn't look like a Korean woman like her brother.
Yeah,
but it's like really some of these people like can hold it together really nice too, and then once like those.
The Jermaine, I call
early 40s hit, and then it just goes fucking wacky.
I call them the Jermaine Dupri years.
When you get how old is Lady Gaga?
Oh, 72? She's posing as a 31-year-old, but let's call a spade a spade.
Which is 31, she says?
Yeah, I like Lady Gaga. Why did I say that? Like, that was shocking. But what I'm trying to say is, like, I think she's great.
So her singing's good, stage performance
great
is good.
Great singer. She's a really good piano player, and she writes and composes her own music.
That's
and
awesome.
She did wacky shit, and she spoke to gay people. I mean, she
did it right.
She got it. But, you know, and also the one thing too is like she was actually speaking about the gays. Like all these pop stars before her, like every blue moon a pop star would be like, I do appreciate my gay fans. You know, so it was nice to get Lady Gaga to be screaming about it.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, she was very big.
Yeah.
Little Monsters.
Speaking of pop stars from the 90s,
yeah, this is going to be great.
Because she can play her ass off. Let him hit me, raise
it, baby, stay with me. No, she can play her ass off.
Yeah, like she did that album with Tony Bennett.
Love.
And, you know, there's
no one listened to that.
Well, I did. I'm a Tony
with her and Tony Bennett. I don't know. I love Tony Bennett. I mean, I don't know what they're doing to keep him alive.
Dude, it's crazy. I was at Bumbershoot in Seattle in 2012, and I got a little too drunk, and he was there, and I was
to Bennett?
I'm like, I'm going to go see some Tony Bennett. And I was so high and drunk that I sat there for a little bit, and I was like, this is sad.
Because
yeah.
Can we play some piano, or someone play a piano? I have a good Tony Bennett impression.
Oh, nice.
Just play any piano.
Any piano, and I can just, because Tony, any jazzy song. But I'll show you how he sings now. Because he used to be like a real belter.
Yeah.
You know, like, so, you know, but now he does the, like, sort of sing.
The talk.
There's a little song I'm going to sing. So.
That's, I mean, almost dead accurate.
I mean, the vibrato.
Yeah.
Never going to be today. You know, same thing as Liza Minnelli. And
so they all, once, I mean, singing's worth
scripting on, it's fucking... verbally fighting through COPD.
Patti LaBelle's the only one who can still sing.
I don't know. Yeah. Hey, everybody having fun up there? Tell us.
Guys.
Hey. Hey, all right.
They
this is an
like...
but goody. That's why the lady is a tramp.
That's what
hey, is my bow tie too tight?
Hey, guys, is it just me or are the lights going on and off? I left my heart in San Francisco.
That's what Lindsay Lohan sounds like
right now.
Let's
all go to the
now.
Movies. Yeah. Hey, does anybody else taste nickels?
Yeah.
Anybody taste a nickel?
Hey, why do I see
the room spinning? I have a headache behind my eye.
Why do I see my brother who died in 1982?
Does anybody see these shadow people coming off the wall?
Is this the end of Ghost, or am I wrapping up a concert?
Hey, that's why the doobity-doo. Hey, anybody see those shadow people coming off the wall?
Hey, is this the sound check or the fifth show of the tour?
Does anyone else feel wet?
He goes, one more. Everybody, give it up. Give it up one more time for ZZ Top. They were very good earlier.
They were good earlier. Let's take a break, and then we'll come back. I want to show you.
Dude,
I wanted Mateo to be here for the...
and I can't wait to watch this.
Oh, what is
Lou that? Sent me a video earlier that we just have to...
I haven't even watched it yet. I'm going to wait to watch it with you.
Okay.
And, very funny.
And we'll be right back. We're hanging out. Mateo Lane. Mateo is going to be headlining... Caroline's Christine.
Go check out Mateo Lane. Very
tomorrow.
Funny. He's in he's right. At Caroline's on Broadway.
Tomorrow night.
Thursday,
June 15th, 9:30 p.m. Get your tickets at carolines.com. Mateo is absolutely fucking hilarious. Very talented. Make sure you check that out. And then we'll be right back with him. It's The Bonfire.
That right there is some B-side Harry Chapin. WLD, it's a Gary Music Day. My last big gig.
You guys ever rock out to Mary Chapin Carpenter?
Ooh. Was she even related? Was she related to Harry Chapin?
I don't know, but I love her.
Yeah, Mary Chapin Carpenter's great.
She is great. I love that you know her.
That's Mateo Lane sitting in with us. I'm Dan Soto. That's Big J. Okerson. Mateo Lane's going to be at Caroline's on Broadway tomorrow night. That's Thursday, June 15th at 9:30. So go to carolines.com and make sure you buy tickets if you're in the tri-state area. He's fucking hilarious. If you're in New York, definitely check him out at Caroline's tomorrow night at 9:30. And you can check out Big J this Friday in Poughkeepsie at Laugh It Up. He's going to be there with Zach Amico and Justin Silver. That's Friday, June 16th, and then Saturday, June 17th, he's going to be at the Cherokee Casino in West Sloan Springs in Oklahoma. Go to BigJComedy.com for tickets now. Do it.
Do it. And Dan, of course, is going to be at the Denver Comedy Works coming home Thursday, June 29th through Saturday, July 1st.
Oh,
get
not...
all your tickets at DanSoto.com.
Are you going to be in the Comedy Condo?
No, yeah. I stay at my mom's.
Damn, because I did a great painting the
I'm
going to
go
month.
Check it out.
You did a great painting.
I did a great painting.
Tim Dillon's staying there. So I'm gonna
nice.
I'll go hang out there.
It's an awesome condo.
Yeah, I gave him
He's
the
getting
condo.
It to himself?
Yeah.
It's a good one by yourself.
That's great.
We had Fenoya there, which is fine, but like it's weirdly none of the walls are attached.
No.
Like up. So like in the master bedroom, like you could hear everything possible.
Oh, really?
It's impossible to like fuck.
Well, I'm gonna go like hang out there, probably like in between shows.
And fuck.
Tim and I are just gonna get to it. He's been opening for me a while.
Oh, Tim is gonna destroy that place with young butts.
Oh yeah, he's gonna get the Grindr in Denver.
Oh.
In Memphis.
No, actually, Grindr in Denver is pretty. It's pretty sad.
Is it really?
Yeah, for the whole week I was on Denver, and I swear to you, I was like, really, I'm not gonna hook up once with anybody.
It was
bad.
It's
at least the downtown area where I was, because it only shows you by the foot.
Straight mountain men.
Yeah.
There's like, I'd like to eat some fucking trail mix and have sex with a woman with wide hips.
Yeah, you drew a Maleficent, right?
I did.
Fucking amazing.
I'm excited to see it.
I was very
what
proud of it.
What painting did you do?
Emily Heller took all the white, so I couldn't do anything else. You couldn't paint
Emily
anything.
Emily Heller did like a self.
There it is.
What?
Oh, yeah.
Well, that's right. Christine took a picture of it.
That's fucking.
Yeah, we were texting about it.
Awesome. At the Bonfire SXM.
Look
on
at
Twitter,
the shading.
On Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat if you want to see Mateo Lane's Maleficent. How do you say it?
Maleficent.
Maleficent. Maleficent. Maleficent.
Maleficent.
Hi, you're being really maleficent right now.
Hi.
I just want to love you.
This is my lesbian voice. My name is Alexis, and my wife and I make our own water.
This is my lesbian voice.
Hi.
Hey, I'm Aaron.
Hey, Aaron.
I'm Daniel Soder.
Hey, okay. I'm Daniel Soder. I played catcher in college.
Do you still play?
Oh, you know, in a city league. On weekends.
Can you describe to the audience what you're wearing?
Right now I'm wearing some Levi's. They're pretty thick. They're pretty tight around my thighs. I got a Bonnie Raitt t-shirt on.
Hey, Dykos, we got to jam out. We have a 7:30 res over at Joe's Crab Shack.
Oh,
Chris!
Oh, so exciting. Oh, thank you.
Chris!
Now, should I wear my dickie or just wear my house coat?
I'm so excited that I watched maybe a minute of this video, but yeah. I know we are all going to come at this.
Lou, explain how you found this video.
Please, Lou.
That we're about to watch.
I just came across it, and it's,
You came across
it.
Man,
what are you, a kid?
There's
are
no
you a
tea.
Kid who just found porn?
Well, now you don't get an explanation, dickheads.
I came across it.
I was over by the train tracks, and
it was after we had Pischetti dinner.
Yeah.
And my mom said I can go to my room and play on the computer.
But Robert
she said
I
play on the machine.
But Robert said that I could go out back until the sun went down, and I went by the tracks, and then I sawed it.
I sawed it.
I sawed it.
Go ahead.
Nope, now you get nothing.
No.
Oh, come on, Lou.
Your jersey came out. Game across it. Are you on Brad's team now? Are you Team Brad? You shut down emotionally because fun of your set of crossed?
Yeah, I'm going back in my shell.
Don't. How'd you come across
I love it? I love Turtle Lou.
I don't really have a story behind it.
You just found it online and you knew we'd love it?
It was so ridiculous, I know you would love it.
But where did you see it online? You were
BuzzFeed.
Looking at, where would you have seen this pop up? BuzzFeed?
Yeah.
And it was on today?
Yeah.
Send me a WorldStar link.
Oh, WorldStar.
All right,
WorldStar is at the forefront of all fucking internet videos.
Well, for me it is.
Yeah.
I was doing show prep, and I know that's your favorite.
Yeah,
so
it is.
That's where
I
did you watch the lady? Did you watch the lady getting arrested, yelling at her? The black lady getting arrested, yelling at her boyfriend. She's like, help me out, nigga. I'm your baby's mama. Right. That's a headline of the video. Help me out, nigga. I'm your baby's mama. While the cop's just dragging her on the ground.
Cops are like, well,
hilarious.
At this point, I don't think he's going to jump in.
It's like a 17-second video. It's just that sentence.
He goes,
just her yelling.
I'm pretty sure Missy's not going to help you out here. Let's just get back into the back of the car. Christine, do you have the video?
Mm-hmm.
Let's play this shit.
Oh, I can't wait. Does he sing rap?
Do you know what it is?
He
so we should explain what it is.
He Janet Jackson's it.
Oh, this sounds fabulous.
So Mateo, to explain to you a little history of the show,
mm-hmm.
we find it very fascinating when either celebrities or children of celebrities try to become musicians. And they do it without actually being...
This is inside the actor's studio.
So what we like to do is dissect it, understand it. Because when you have rich parents, you believe you can make music.
When you have rich parents, you do believe you can make music.
I am losing my mind.
So Tommy Hilfiger's son, Paris, right, was a rapper. What was his name?
Paris Hilfiger?
That sounds about
Tom,
right.
Tom Hanks' son, who thinks he's black.
Oh, Mateo.
Chet Hayes. I mean, you're right. Now you're in the Bonfire's wheelhouse.
That's mm-hmm. That's our free bird. That episode of when I found out about Chet Hayes, I
Rob Schneider's daughter has a huge hit out.
Okay,
really?
First off,
yeah.
Did not know that. I didn't know that fucking Deuce Bigelow's daughter was fucking dropping heat. It's a hit?
It's a huge hit.
In the United States?
I didn't know he had a daughter.
Because I think she tries her hardest not to associate with
him. It's called, give me a disc, give me like a techno beat. Give me a techno beat. I'm going to do it. No, can you get instrumental?
Get my instrumentals up.
Here we go. Oh, Dan. Danarino.
That's what I was thinking.
Dantanos.
Dan.
Shambalama Dan Dan.
Hey, you're like,
Dan,
your
making,
dad
copies. Making copies. Making copies. Making copies. Dan, making copies. Dan, the man.
Making copies.
Dan Areno.
Making copies.
Dan Alicious.
Making
Dan Squares. Dan
Cuter. This is the actual song. Her name's Elle King. And it's called America's Sweetheart.
Yeah,
I think your words will make me black and blue. Black.
Does she have Schneider face?
We'll see it.
If by Schneider face not attractive, yes.
Well, really?
Isn't that Rob Schneider as the lion from The Wizard of Oz?
She looks like she's 40. She looks like she's Rob Schneider's sister.
Yeah, really.
The hair extensions make me the most upset.
She has a lot of room between her titties.
I don't want to be a pop star. I'm afraid. I'm afraid of what the crowd's going to think. Oh, God. Dad. The Manimal movie paid for this. Oh, they said I never had a voice. I got a voice.
She's not at all expected her to look like.
Yeah, no.
I met her once. I had to open for Rob Schneider one weekend, which was a horrific experience. He almost fired me on the spot and forced me to wear a suit and play clean, which I was like, all right,
really?
So I guess I just shouldn't talk because I'm so gay. And then she came backstage and she was very nice, but I'll never forget her saying, I'm just going to go to the yacht tomorrow.
Is Rob Schneider living that kind of life?
I think he's made a pretty penny from his movies. But I don't think there's a lot of income coming in now.
She's a little confident porker, huh?
I don't like the way she sings, like she runs.
All this cow.
Now my dad's got movies and can afford some studio time. I've got the attitude of a diner waitress.
She's like, hey, can I get that soup? And she goes, honey, you can get that soup when these cheeseburgers get to table 26. Wow, is your dad Rob Schneider? I'm not going to tip you.
Rob Schneider was like, honey, if I buy you the studio time, will you stop fucking black guys at the house while I'm gone?
And she goes, Dad, I can't.
You like who likes you.
Yeah. He's like, they smell so good.
Look how short her arms are. She's a disproportionately built woman.
She's a T-Rex in a weave. You know.
Oh, that's great. I'm doing big. All right. Well,
she really can't blow her nose or anything. Her hands don't touch her face.
Oh, no. I do think she's probably pretty talented. But she shouldn't have worn this outfit.
Yeah, this is, why would you do that to yourself?
She's like a pirate mixed with.
She looks like the
Susan
white
Boyle.
She looks like a real G.I. Joe, like someone clipped her legs into the fucking dick piece.
She also looks, she also looks like she's successful to like a land developer, like a wife of a successful land developer.
Mark bought all this land when no one told him to.
I don't think successful is the right word. Yeah. Just a land developer.
She looked definitely, that's a single wide body.
She looks like if she farts in those pants, she's going to have to like push it down to come out of her ankle.
Looks like she farted in her pants and she's waiting for any moment to get it out.
Or like when you jump in the pool.
The pool,
You push it down.
You push, you're like, no, that wasn't fart bubbles. That was my, for some reason, my bathing suit just became a fucking parasail.
She goes, every time I stand, it looks like I'm in a pool.
Is that a guitar? They just put strings on her gun.
I'll be honest, I'm kind of into it. This is for you. My pussy song.
Do you think Rob Schneider wrote it?
Dan the man, Dan Areno.
This is a Kia song.
Yeah. It's a what song?
This is Kia.
I do it. Just do it.
This is that one. Yeah, that's a famous one. My neck, my back.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Pussy and my crack. I'm into this.
Is that what it is?
Yeah.
I mean, if she's out there working the road, God bless her.
Yeah.
You know? You got to go put in the time.
After we ripped her into shreds.
Yeah, but that's...
Oh, she had it coming.
But that's an appetizer because here's the deal. Number one, she's not riding off it. Oh, here's the real video. I loved this video.
Oh, Kaya?
Shake your body, don't stop. Is it Kaya?
It's Kaya.
Do
it. Yeah. Do it now. Lick it good. After she was on this show, she competed in the America's Next Best Female Rapper.
That was a show?
VH1. Like next
a good
female
good job, VH1.
Yeah. Okay. Done.
But gays are the problem.
Is that, yeah.
I'm just saying after this, it's like, but we're the problem.
Yeah.
You guys I don't think a lot of black girls want their butt cracks licked.
I disagree. Yeah. I feel like more straight people I'm talking to are getting their assholes licked.
She's I'm all about a good asshole licking. I'll take it, I'll give it. But I mean...
She goes, my neck, my back, my pussy, and that'll do.
Yeah, yeah.
And bring your ass up here, I ain't gonna kiss you.
But black guys, you know, that was always the thing about black guys, don't really eat pussy, but it depends. If you go...
That's
Lou,
the thing?
Lou, you're a black dude that went to a white school...
It's my favorite thing to do on the fucking planet.
Yeah. No, I believe that. Yeah. I'm saying, but
same stereotype of gay men.
But I almost think the joke is
so stupid. so dumb.
I think that joke is so told at this point, and I think a lot of plenty, maybe even a majority of black guys eat pussy, but there are still a faction you talk to that they're appalled by the notion.
Why?
I don't know. There's a Dominican comedian that I was talking to. Name him, but he was like, I don't eat pussy at all.
Yeah, I'll tell you why I think so.
I think there's only one Dominican comedian.
Well, yeah, but you see what I'm
yeah, yeah.
It's, in the black community, there's a lot of weight on machismo. And I think that's like you're being like a bitch, like you're going to, you know what I mean? Like it's,
somehow you're a faggot if you eat a pussy. Yeah.
To some degree. That's why I learned that early when I was in the black comedy circuit, man. Like, you really even make a joke if you were like, oh, that guy's whatever, I'll suck his dick later and blah, blah, you know, as a joke. They just don't like the joke. They're like, whoa. They don't want to hear the words sometimes. It's weird. Like, and that was when I was doing like kind of like the hood, like black rooms. Is because, yeah, it's just like a lot of machismo there. It's like it's what's clinged on to more than anything.
Well, yeah, because
up
I mean,
there is like, you know, your rep, your status is
I'd
like
love to send them to a drag show.
It'd be absolutely great.
It'd be great.
I'll tell you what, we did it. We filmed with a bunch of thuggy black dudes for a Comedy Central webisode thing I did. And as the day goes on, the sillier things we made them do, they did kind of go in. Like, we made them all run outside and buy ice cream and shit. And
I think that most people, I mean, you know, not just being black, but anybody who puts on a type of persona, machismo, whatever it is, I think it's a little bit of a role play.
Yeah, you think they're
See
like,
what I mean?
Do you think they're clinging to it to hide up insecurities?
Yeah, of course.
No, there absolutely is. But when you're living a role,
yes,
like how long before it becomes...
reality.
Do you know what I mean? Reality.
Like, yeah, I always think about that with like super alpha guys who are like, bro, I'm just here to fucking smash pussy and crush jaws.
And, be like,
and you're like, at one point in eighth grade, they had to be like, I'm gonna crush pussy. And they're like, I'm gonna
they had to evolve from somewhere.
I'm gonna do it.
I'm gonna get pussy.
Yeah.
I wanna touch all the pussy.
Can I say something to you that I forgot to tell you? Speaking of celebrities' kids,
yeah.
I had a real genuine, this is gonna be funny because I'm making a joke, but a real cool moment I didn't tell them about yet, at the Comedy Store. Like, you know how influenced I am by Dice and how much...
Yes, of course, absolutely.
When I was a kid and how, you know, me and my stepfather, all this corny shit I've said 1,000 times. Eleanor,
yeah,
who's Dice's ex, I still haven't met Dice and bullshit with him ever. She goes, I have some people out here that want to meet you. And she brings me outside, and it was to meet Max,
his
son, who I didn't know. I know who he is and of him. And he was like genuinely like a big fan of mine.
Oh,
that's
wow.
Awesome.
I genuinely was like saying like quoting stuff from my special.
That's
wow.
And I was just kind of like, that's just a neat thing to kind of come around.
You haven't met Dice Clay yet?
No, not really. No,
that's like awesome though.
Passed by, but just the fact that his son, like it would kind of remind me of that Chappelle thing they keep saying. It's like, his kids aren't impressed that he's Dave Chappelle. They're impressed that he knows Kevin Hart.
Yeah.
So that was just kind of a neat thing that's like, at the time, being 12 years old and watching it with my stepfather.
Yeah.
His specials to his children now are like a fan of mine. I thought that was such a
that's
cool
That's fucking
friend.
Awesome. That's great. And that happened last week in L.A.?
Yeah, I thought that was so cool.
That's
and
fucking
sweetheart
badass.
Of a kid, man. Really cool kid.
Will Smith punched
wow,
Mike.
Is that his son,
how much
right?
is he? Yeah, they're both.
Oof, the but one on the right can get
the
it.
The one on the
hot.
Left, the one on the left looks like young Dice. I mean,
yeah.
That's the one I meant.
Yeah, the
Max.
One on the left's cute too, and I'm not saying that, but the one on the right's like, hey, Roll. damn, he's got some good looking kids.
Good for Dice. Good job, yeah. Dice.
Hey. Dice!
Way to dump a load in the right there.
Your fucking jizz has good-looking kids in it, you fucking cunt.
Mary, Mary, quite contrary. Trim that pussy, it's so damn hairy.
Ugh! Now.
You ever hear when Howard and had Dice and Richard Simmons on all at the same time?
Oh, yeah.
It's great.
Yeah, that's one of my favorites. I say... It's 7:27.
Yeah, we're gonna have. Let's take our last
break because we can just ride this one out till we come back.
And we have one more.
All right, this is our last break.
Last break, but then this is definitely gonna take a half hour.
It is absolutely.
And we don't want to do that thing where we start and then stop.
And we're gonna have to use pause.
Oh yeah.
Okay.
We use pause a lot.
Oh, perfect.
We'll be right back. Mateo Lane headlining tomorrow at Caroline's. Go to carolines.com for tickets. We'll be right back. It's the Bonfire.
And now, back to the Bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
Meets you at the border. That's where he walked out of the Huey Lewis Jimmy Buffett concert. Yeah, that's Jimmy Buffett, Son of a Sailor, because it's Gary music on the Bonfire today.
J. Buff, rest in peace, Gary. Happy birthday.
Big ups, Gary. It's the Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder. That's Big J. Okerson. In studio with us, Mateo Lane. We were talking Celine Dion. We were talking Janet Jackson jerk-off videos. Then we started talking about kids musicians, Rob Schneider's 50-year-old waitress diner daughter.
Then we jumped into Black Guys Not Liking the Pussy. We have one call on the line. It is Saletta from Oakland who wants to ask what we're talking about Black Guys Not...
Saletta,
am I saying it right? Saletta?
Yes, I'm here.
Hi, Saletta.
Can you turn on your radio, though, too? Just because it will...
Oh, yeah, I'll turn it off.
All right, thanks.
Hi, Saletta.
Caught me just in time. Hey, how you guys doing?
Good, how you doing?
Hey, how are you? It's nice to meet you, Saletta. I'm not arguing that black, but I do believe many, many black men love deep pussy. I just know publicly a lot of black guys when I was growing up would just say they didn't.
Yeah, it was kind of like, I think in the early 90s, 80s and early 90s, black guys eating pussy were similar to white dudes being able to dance. And then all of a sudden in the 2000s, everything changed. And everyone's like, Justin Timberlake came out. And black dudes started eating box.
And as a gay man, I don't care about any of this.
Justin Timberlake popped up. Black guys started popping down.
Okay, because I called you guys in the middle, and I know you guys. Sometimes y'all say some crazy. And please stop saying black room. What the hell is a black room?
No, that's what it's called in the comedy community.
Is like, that a term?
Yeah, that's a term in the comedy community.
Wait, what do you mean? Oh, like the black comedy room.
Yeah, but she means like when you work in a black room.
It's the same as like there's a gay room. There's a whole thing.
There's like
there's Hispanic rooms.
Corporates.
It sounds like a dungeon where there are only black people there. Welcome you. Like, it's not inviting.
The club I started off at, God bless it, the club I started off at was like such a treat to start at because the Laugh House in Philly, the open mic night was 250 people sold out every single week. It was amazing.
And we're kind people. And we do, so we do eat, and that's why we're kind, because our men eat pussy.
Oh.
So I just want to let you know that makes me happy.
Yeah,
so
I'm glad it does. Okay. I mean, that's why we do it.
Absolutely.
That's why we go down, is to
make
you guys happy.
I love how, like, that sounded so sweet and inspiring, but
it was about getting her box eaten.
Yeah, that was great.
She goes, and I just want to say, we all have blood, we all have bones, and we all love eating that pussy.
That one day, a black man and a white woman can stand atop a mountain, and he could eat that pussy. Oh,
he can nibble. He can nibble on that pink box.
Forever.
I'm gonna say, if you don't think black men eat pussy, ask white women.
That should be great. She should be on this show.
That's their froyo.
Real talk.
You just made Black Lou pump fist the air. Like he just scored a hockey goal.
Well,
thank you guys.
Of course, thanks for calling.
Thanks for calling in, sweetie.
Bye.
All right, now let's get to the
sweetheart.
Yeah, our fans are the fucking best. Let's get to the issues at hand.
Oh, please.
We were talking about rich kids. We were talking about famous kids.
Now we've gone at Jaden Smith before.
We have talked about Jaden Smith.
Ridiculous. We've gone at him before because
he's
really
ridiculous.
His parents have been telling him he is a future king his entire life,
or queen in some aspects,
or in many aspects a queen
because he wears like dresses now.
But it's like that pursuit of happiness never stopped for him. Like they were like, you could do anything. Don't allow talent or rational thought or anything.
Well, Will Smith said he wanted to make sure he could teach his son that 2 + 2 doesn't need to equal 4.
Which is wrong. That is wrong. That's wrong, and you're dumb.
He is, I mean, this kid is...
the embodiment of confidence.
He's just...
All confidence. He just thinks everything he nails, so he put up a song.
Extraordinarily, just out of the gates... unlikable.
He can't
because who likes untalented, confident people?
Yeah, you're right.
They're the worst.
Yeah.
I wish I had a sliver of this kid's confidence.
Oh, my God.
A sliver.
First
if I did, I'd be a millionaire.
And you wouldn't be on the show. You would not be
I would 100% be on this show.
Oh, okay.
If I ever make a music video, will you please make fun of it?
Oh, 1,000%.
Thank you.
I will be there. We'll make fun of it while you're filming it.
Can we also be in it?
Yeah, also.
Yeah, of course.
I need to keep my SAG dues up. If you could just. So this has been watched 73,000 times, and the verdict's out that only
73,000 times?
And only 145 people.
Came out today.
Well, that's not enough.
It just dropped. But let's watch this music video. It's Jaden Smith with the song Batman. Keep that fucking mouse close to the pause button.
Dude, this is...
First off, shot beautifully. The music video is shot gorgeous.
Well, his dad probably made him get major directors.
He's already a bad actor and all he did was get up. This is embarrassing. I'm embarrassed. Can we pause real quick?
Yeah.
He is? Okay, I just want to explain something real quick.
Let me just explain what it is. He's out in the field and he's asleep. All of a sudden there's a noise. He sees what looks to be a bat signal and starts yelling, fuck a bunch, like he just choked a woman to death during sex.
And he looks like happened. Tracy Chapman.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's sort of dressed like a...
Hey, I'm in a fast car.
He's dressed like a fat girl who works at Hot Topic.
Yeah. But or the girlfriend of a low-level hockey player.
Yeah, he's all like a lot of straps and...
And from the get-go, he starts overacting.
Yeah.
So I've never been more embarrassed in my entire life.
It's 20 seconds. There's been no song, and you're already embarrassed.
Oh, I can't. I don't even know if I can now you handle
know why
the rest.
Now you know why we took our last break so early.
There's been the light twinklings of music happening.
Yeah. He's been
not talent, just music.
He's been fucking.
No, I'm saying in this song so far, there's been some light twinklings in the background.
All right. There's a bat signal. He's
which
upset.
Looks like I drew it in with MS Paint.
He's got a glass.
Oh, he was drinking.
He's circling. And it's a flashback.
Okay, Mr. Wayne.
Oh, so he's supposed to be Batman.
No, he's going to be Batman?
The song's called Batman.
He's drinking.
Go back. Was that a French, una produzione, or was that Italian?
Yeah, you're bilingual, so you can read it. What does that say?
Presenta una produzione. Why is it in Italian?
Because he's fancy, Matteo. Batman speaks Italian. Yeah, I call
presenta
it Italian.
Presenta una produzione.
I say it like my grandma. I call it Italian.
He's checking his phone.
This is
a long build-up. How long is the song? The video is only 4 minutes.
The rumors of the Batman circulating your name. What do you have to say to God?
Who am I speaking?
This is an inquiry.
With whom am I speaking? People don't talk that way, especially him.
Why does he keep moving around that ice?
What is
he drinking?
He looks like Boy George.
Yeah.
It might be Boy George.
He also looks like he's doing math problems on a blank.
You think he's jumping out of the closet at some point, Jaden Smith?
I think he has already ran miles out of it.
Oh, really?
If we've gotten to this point, yes.
What's he writing?
Oh, God.
He wrote Batman on the mirror.
But real quick, his A's are just triangles. So I want everyone to know now that already shows that he's different. He's better than us because his A's are triangles. Now I will say this: his body can get it.
Bruce Wayne. Oh, he's Bruce Wayne, but he's like a modern Bruce Wayne.
The credits already. What?
Batman, 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 Joker just put me on acid. You wanna wait like a maverick, that makes I'm happy.
Pause real quick.
Batman, this Batman, is, Batman, you're a fucking asshole.
I just wanna say.
What
it.
An asshole. What a complete and utter, Black Lou is upset. What, are you mad?
Yeah, he stole that. That's from Drake. That Jumpman, 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 y'all being up to something.
I don't like.
Okay,
I don't
but
listen
to be
to,
fair,
I,
Drake like a, looks exactly like Liza Minnelli.
Yeah, and also
let's
to sound
not
like,
forget he was in a wheelchair and his eyes are on the side of his head, and he's also half Jewish. I hate Drake.
The other half's amoeba.
Oh please, I hate him.
And I sound like a white stepdad where I go, I don't listen to Drake.
I'm unfamiliar with the songs.
Well, Mister,
what does he play?
Drake. What's his band's name? Go back. So he said, Christine, we're going to be doing a lot of going back.
The music video is half over with the song barely even started.
And so he's on top of it.
Yeah. Batman, 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 Joker just put me on acid.
You wanna wait like saving? A maverick,
that makes I'm happy. Batman, Batman,
fashion.
Batman,
is this just like
fashion.
A really what the LA Geek Squad looks like?
I don't know, but this is so bad.
I love he just had the outfit.
like that's this white Batman costume. He originally brought it out for Kanye and Kim's wedding like 2 years ago. So he just like did this based on the fact that he has a white Batman.
Yeah, he went to Kanye and Kim's wedding in a white Batman.
That must have been thrilling.
He goes, guys, somebody shows up, you're like, fuck, dude, fuck off.
Also,
like someone should yell at him like a kid that his parents never did. Be like, fuck off, dude.
Let me tell you who I am as a person. I'd be like this when I first see him. I go, oh, cool, he wore a Batman costume. And then when his cape unintentionally knocked my drink off the table, I'd be like, all right, you motherfucker, come on.
Yeah.
Watch your goddamn cape.
Hey, dude, your fucking, your arm spikes are getting in the goddamn...
Your arm shriekings are fucking everything up. I mean, All right, so now go back to the...
I just can't believe I get called faggot all the time, and this guy gets away scot-free, running around in a weird Batman outfit.
Can I tell you this right now?
I've been yelling at the screen all day. Yeah.
But also, you have a real gripe. You have a real gripe about that. All right, let's go, because he should be... I mean, this is...
I learned nothing since last year. You got the renegade fabrics.
He's just dancing in the street?
He's bouncing in the street, drinking that water again on a hill.
No, he was pissing.
Oh.
Go back. He was pissing on the hill.
It's weird. Why would you have your hair cover your line of vision?
That was really weird. He's just pissing on a hill.
Also, where do his dreads go when he puts on the Batman costume? You have to have short hair if you're wearing a Batman suit.
He unsnaps them.
Can we make our own version called Superman?
Superman.
With
Superman.
The same beat.
Watch, see?
Oh, he is pissing.
It's like a really dumb Halloween.
Ain't got a mattress. I heard you married a Porsche. That's
what?
That's all in the past. Plus we got very divorced. You ain't ready for the war. Skywalker with a force.
Okay, hold on. Real awful. Quick.
I mean, what's he talking
did
about?
Did he get this from Hooked on Phonics?
It.
What's this?
That's not it. Jumpin', KD. Oh, that was...
Did he lift from this then? But, like, is that legal?
That's where he stole it from.
He stole it from
so
Drake.
So basically all this cadence and how he's putting his words together is all from Drake.
So he's a rich kid that's just taking what he wants and doing with it what he
but
chooses.
But does Drake know that he took it? Like,
Drake probably does not give a fuck.
I'm going to tweet him right now.
They're like,
tweet it,
they're like, stolen? What you mean?
He goes,
2 plus 2, 6.
He goes, last time I checked, the earth isn't round. Nor is it flat, it's a hexagon. Because I choose it to be.
So you're saying stealing is defined as I took this? Because if you're going with that definition, then yes, I stole. But
you're limited.
That's not how I define it. My father told me I can define stealing however I want.
Because I also think that, my thought's not limited to know what crime and punishment is.
The problem is that he's a very good-looking young man, and it's embarrassing he's behaving this way. My Italian mother would never let me behave this way.
She's like, you are not a Batman.
There's something about somebody there to, like, you know, even out that spoon. You know, you gotta, like...
Yeah, you gotta have someone, you gotta take
you
a couple ass whoopings.
Someone who's just telling you to shut the fuck up.
Do you need one person to tell you can do anything, and you need one person to tell you ain't shit?
Well, in my case, I had all of high school telling me, so, I mean, maybe he just needs to take my place and go back to high school.
He was homeschooled.
Were you very badly bullied in high school?
Oh, I mean, please, of course.
Yeah? Well, I don't know, you know what's very weird? I went to a predominantly black high school. And, it was very black. And I would say, like, the two of the most, maybe the most popular kids, but two people that seemed to not have much of a problem were Angelo and Andre, the two clearly gay guys.
Hey, sister friend!
Yeah, and Angelo was a white Italian kid, and Andre was black, and they both just seemed to, like, and by the way, like, didn't take shit, so if you were going to kind of bully them, they were, like, very flamboyant and
big. I wasn't out. There's also something about people who are out that don't, that it's almost actually...
I don't know if they were both, I mean, they... Probably were.
I mean, his name's Angelo.
I know, but no one really talked. It makes sense. Like, no one even asked, almost.
Yeah.
Just didn't kind of ask about it.
Well, you don't have to. Like, Angelo, how was writing class? Ah, girl!
Yeah, basically, yeah.
So it was pretty well known that they were both gay. And
again, I was always the wrong. I was trying to follow everything, so I'd be like, Angelo's tucking his jeans into his socks. That looks pretty badass.
That's
and then
so
you come
cute.
To school the next day, and someone's like, Jay, don't Angelo your socks.
Yeah.
Let me just say this. This is how boring this song is, that we're talking about Angelo from your high school.
Yeah.
That's how boring
Angelo. Blowing dudes in the gym locker.
Sucking off the teacher to get a good grade.
Angelo. shut up. I mean, this is like all.
His sister's song is much better. Batman, Batman, Batman. Please save the day for the demons.
I was sleeping, he was leaning. We drove right into a precinct. He is. Batman, Batman, Batman. Why you look fired in hell?
Don't get the album was sold. But this shit might fly off the show. Batman, Batman, Batman. He's dancing? Bad.
This is like a really, this is like someone who's not creative trying to be creative.
This is what most of my art school experience looked like, actually.
Everyone's dressed like superheroes.
I think all those people there were just a bunch of disappointed fathers.
Yeah.
But Jaden has got a nice body. This is embarrassing. This is what I do on Saturday nights.
Hey, you want to get together with a superhero buddies and gay off?
You guys want to put on tight costumes and just wrestle?
I like how they try blurring out the McDonald's, but it's just a blurrier.
It's just a blurry McDonald's.
Why are all the superheroes' faces blurred?
Because they didn't sign releases.
Batman, Batman, and the man who is a spider. The man who is a spider.
A man who's better than good, you'd say he's super.
Yeah.
Batman.
Fantastic man. Fantastic man.
Ant-Man.
He's really good at stuff because he's not from here.
Literally, the feeling I'm feeling right now is what I feel like my dad feels like when my brother and I were both like, we're gay. Shame, embarrassment. Actually, emptiness. I'm empty.
By the way,
on the
he's
inside.
Walking away shamed, it seems, at the end of the video.
But, well, he should
and
be.
And he says Finn at the end, like it proved.
So it started in Italian and ended in French. They can't even get that right. Oh, it's not over. There's an extra special feature.
He is,
Is it a Celine Dion music video now?
When the bus just hit him.
Sir!
Just some fucking coyote comes out of nowhere and just bites his ass.
Sire.
He's a pompous little dude.
Unlikable.
Does he have a statement out about the video?
Oh, but look.
Look up to see if he has tweets.
That was really embarrassing. I don't like feeling embarrassed for other people, and that's actually the worst. And I've seen people. You know, we watched Madonna tumble.
Yeah.
I always want to see more videos of him. Does he have anything?
You got to watch him being interviewed. It's out of control.
We've done that 1,000 times. But is he just not?
Can you have me back next time you have anything Jaden Smith related? Thank you.
Yeah, he'll be our Jaden Smith correspondent.
So wait. Zach in Canada says there's a good Jaden Smith song. Zach, you're opening yourself up for scrutiny here, buddy.
Zach, you to never call back.
We're going
to
make you stay in the Northwestern Territories.
Zach, you there? Can you put Zach on the horn? Zach, what's up, buddy?
Zach, we'd love your explanation.
Hey, so he actually has a song called Fast, where he's rapping, rolling around on the floor in a garage in a dress, but it's produced by Childish Gambino, and it's not half bad.
All right, here it is. Right,
that's always good when something's not half bad.
Not half bad, but I don't like
it's like when you're at Applebee's and you're eating a bunch of things, you're like, I guess the apple blossom's not the worst. But it doesn't make it a good restaurant.
Yeah, I still hate Applebee's.
Of course. Why you drive so fast? Girl, where you gotta go? Girl, where you gotta go? Baby, you should try and drive slow. I just want to say gay men also say girl. I'm just trying to stay alive on the big screen. When you coming up to drive, all the kids scream. Zach, you promised this was half... Okay. I promise.
It's a minute 14 seconds.
And it's really not bad for rap.
What the hell? Well, this is horrible for rap.
This is, yeah.
And I know nothing of rap.
I mean, like, Kendrick Lamar is great.
I get what you're saying. I get what you're saying, Zach. It's like, at least it's like formidable music.
Yeah.
Isn't this the same song we just listened to without the Batman costume? Batman.
He's just rolling around on a garage.
He also dresses like a real queef. He's dressed like a female tennis pro right now.
Billie Jean King.
He's dressed like Maria Sharapova.
And he's like,
he's wearing a skirt and a tight hoodie.
Like she's playing in
he
a cloudy.
Looks like he's wearing like grandma's house coat and leggings.
Yeah. He's trying to be. He's one of those people that's trying so hard to be different that it makes him look like a dickhead.
Yeah. Do you think Will Smith and Jada Pinkett are just like so self-involved
that they couldn't help but love it?
Yes. I think they were like.
They even said in an interview that they want their family to be like titans, like an empire together. I mean, they think they're doing it.
No, they are not, unless they are planning on failing so much that people forget their name and then surprising them with actually something
decent.
You
understand these kids are so young, dude. They still have a shot to just act in a movie that shoots them to the next level, and they can get put into those movies.
He has these unbelievably shot videos, and there's now one's called Scarface.
They have so much money.
So much money.
Oh,
they can
so much money. Like, do they film this in Italy?
Play this, Lou.
How can a guy who I've never heard of has an album out have so many singles and videos?
I know.
And why do the videos take place in, like, these locations and shit?
Highly produced videos.
Highly produced.
Sorry, guys. I'm in New Zealand shooting my new video for a song.
Yeah, they're in Italy. Look, that sign's all in Italian.
Oh, he's wearing a mammoth hoodie. That's so gross.
My people must have been so confused.
Like, what?
We heard Will Smith, but this look like... Something bad.
Here's the thing about his videos. He's giving that, like, I've been so beaten up by life, I can't take it look. And you're like, no. You had a very nice life.
My robot butler broke down the other day.
My dad cut me off from his Fresh Prince of Bel Air royalty checks.
Now I only get the Muhammad Ali checks.
It really is the same thing as Tom Hanks, where Will Smith is so lovable. And he creates a piece
of
shit.
Oh, Will Smith is so hot. I would... Oh, my God.
But Will Smith, it's like, I knew Will...
He's from my neighborhood. I gotta love Will Smith.
Will Smith's husband is really hot, too.
Oh, boy. Claws are out.
She was so hot in Menace Society, and then I don't know what happened.
I love who goes to Italy, goes to some hill town, where literally they're known for, like, their truffle and, like, I don't know, pasta, and he's...
There's a negro in there smashing up with the cave.
I'll make sure he don't touch our special god that we use for the feast.
By the way, isn't it crazy to say that...
Ma che questo ragazzo che è venuto qua?
Get in jiggy with it, that I'm never in the mood to hear, even if my team's up by 20 and I'm at a sporting event.
How hot Will Smith
I'm never excited to listen to Getting Jiggy With It, but... That song is better than anything his children have done a million times.
Luke, crank it.
Because it's catchy, if nothing else.
But just because you're talented doesn't mean your kids are going to be talented. Judy Garland's the exception, all right? Liza's talented.
Yeah.
Sorry to bring it back.
Oh, but look at that. He was so likable, we let him rap.
Big Willie style is great.
I think he's hot. I love everything about this.
I still love the...
Nah.
Oh, yeah, he won a Grammy.
Even his son's out there trying to get make like Fellini movies. And fucking...
Yeah, it's not. Look at that! Look at that! That's clearly on a soundstage in L.A.
Man, Dancing Like an Egyptian was a hit from the 80s to the 90s. Okay, Will Smith. All right, there's some naked... Okay. There's some naked men. I see some naked men in there.
Dude, I mean, so he saw this. Jaden must have been watching this as a kid, and he was like, oh, Will Smith has an older son that just the two of us
think
about.
Football. Or played football.
Played football, but I think he's, like, pretty normal.
Well,
I'm using this, like, sorbet to clear out the Jaden Smith out of my mouth.
And it's still not good enough.
Still not good enough.
I thought Jaden was the first.
No, he's got an older son from another wife, and that's why they don't talk about it, because it's not a part of Jada.
Yeah. So is Jada the problem? Do you think
100%.
Well, Jada used to date Tupac.
Jada Smith is also... Well, she's the one who has no talent and a lot of confidence.
Oh.
And then bestowed that, bequeathed that onto her children.
Oh, and Will seems like he's just a dad. Will seems like a dad that can't say no.
You know, it's funny, too, and we have talked on the show before, too. She tries to be like, well, I'm not great at anything, so let me go try to do a bunch. And she's a heavy metal singer.
Okay.
A metal band. You know that?
Oh, yes, I do. I mean, she screams, yeah.
Ridiculous. But yeah, but it's not like a good band of
good
music. She's terrible.
Of course.
And,
I wouldn't trust her with a plant.
And her acting,
you know what?
For me, her acting's always been like, she's never been like the thing.
Trey Smith, Will Smith's older son, who looks strikingly like, ugly Lenny Kravitz. He's the
The Will Smith family is very good looking. I mean, Will is hot and Jada Pinkett Smith. I've always been like, I'm saying her name wrong, but she's hot too.
At a time, she was smoking hot.
Remember she wore that wig in Nutty Professor?
Yeah.
It looked like a cancer wig.
Yeah, but he was a star football player and was even offered a scholarship. But instead of going to college, he followed his... Oh, God, he's in music.
He's going into music, too?
He's an accomplished DJ. Sure he is.
So is Paris Hilton. What does that say?
Yeah.
Ugh. Oh, so now he's an accomplished DJ.
Oh, there's some songs.
There's a music featuring the two young kids.
Oh, dude, this is a fucking Will Smith family
joint.
We
only got 3 minutes left.
Play it, Christine. Find You Somewhere. It's
called
ACE.
Oh, you're right.
That's the older brother featuring Jaden and Willow.
It's starting out like an Usher video.
Usher.
Is Storm there
from X-Men?
Like,
you just sent me a text and like, Storm, mistress of the elements.
Welcome. This looks like a dance party that was in eighth grade into someone's basement.
And you're like making out with someone and it braces on.
Put on No Doubt again.
Oh, I love No Doubt.
And you got him right. You can see smoke going through the light.
What's up, everybody?
Did my butt direct this video? Yeah. Why is it so gay?
That might be the line of the episode. Did my butt direct this episode because it's so gay?
I mean, it's so.
This is the physical manifestation of what gay sex looks like. If gay sex was a music video.
Yeah, I've done this many a time.
Yeah. Can you score a butt fuck?
can you score a butt fuck?
Because let me watch it. You're like, okay. Stead.
And these poor women who have to like dance around. That's the most embarrassing part, is that these accomplished dancers who are like 30 years old have to listen to the Kid Smith family.
And he's fucking had to. And like Jaden Smith, he believes he's been nailing it at music for fucking years.
He's also a
genius.
He's a child rapping about adult relationships, which is very frustrating.
Yeah. Yeah. Like, baby girl,
you're not there for me no more. You're like, you're in the eighth grade.
The only thing he can think about is how great his nanny cooks.
Yeah, he's like, I like it when dad lets me stay up late.
I need you here to open some jars.
I'm not allowed. PB and J. They put a lock on the basement door because there's a wet bar downstairs. I'm not allowed to put a drink on the pool table. They get mad. Oh, here's Willow's. Do I turn it up?
Willow's. Is this still the song?
Yeah.
It sounds like a different song.
Best is when they had an interview where he's like, I write my own books, and then I go back and I read them 6 months from now, and they're my favorite.
I feel like he said that.
That's right.
You're like, you're a fucking dick.
I write my own books, go back and read them. I fucking forgot about that.
I write my own books and go back and read it. Jaden Smith, if newborn babies could speak, they would be the most intelligent beings on planet Earth.
No, they wouldn't. They would shit their pants and scream for a tit.
Yeah, that's like when people say, like, those movies come out where they're like, we've developed a technology where you can use 100% of your brain. You're like, you're not supposed to use 100% of your brain, or else you'd be having memories shitting, coming, and fucking...
Yeah, you'd be dead.
And also freaking out.
I vote we sterilize.
Guys, I'm using 100% of my brain.
I say we sterilize them. Let's sterilize them.
Is that what Britney's doing? Using 100% of her brain? Because she looks a lot like that.
Fluids coming out of the sides. Matteo Lane, thank you.
Guys, thanks so much for having me.
Make sure you go check out Matteo tomorrow night. That's Thursday, June 15th at 9:30 p.m. at Caroline's. Get your tickets before the show. Fill that place up for him. Let him know when you see there you heard him on the Bonfire. He's absolutely hilarious. Check that out. Of course, also Dan Soder is going to be at the Denver Comedy Works. Woo! Thursday, June 29th through Saturday, July 1st. If you want to fuck Tim Dillon, he'll be at the condo by himself. Get your tickets at dansoder.com.
Also, the Netflix Netflix special coming out July 4th.
July 4th. Hell yeah.
As part of the series
Netflix
called
Half Hour.
The Stand-Ups. It will be on Netflix. Myself, Nate Bargatze, Fortune Feimster, Dion Cole, Beth Stelling, and Nikki Glaser all have six half-hour comedy Netflix specials that you can check out. You can check out Big J. Okerson in Poughkeepsie at Laugh It Up this Friday with Zach Amico and Justin Silver. And then June 17th, he's going to be at the West Sloan Springs at the Cherokee Casino West Sloan
Springs.
This
Saturday.
That's in Oklahoma. So if you're in the Oklahoma
area. Mike's always going to be with me, too, so come check that out.
So go to BigJComedy.com to get all those tickets. We love you guys. Thanks
for
listening.
Follow us, Bonfire SXM on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. And Skankfest coming real soon, everybody. Catch you next week. Crackle, crackle.